In this video, I'm going to show you guys how to control client's hair before installing or sewing in weaves. This video is for beginners and it's also for those of us that cannot really make or back hairstyle. So I just made it very detailed for anybody that wants to really learn how to make or back. Okay, first, let's assume that this is the client actually wants a center part hairstyle. So yeah, the first thing you need to do is to use a tail comb to just section out, to part out the center parting. Make sure that the parting is on a straight line. Then use a tail comb to still section out the portion of the first cornrow. But in this case, and since she doesn't have hair in front, so you have to section it out or bring out hairs from the very beginning, very starting point of her edges or her hair, or where the hair, her hair actually starts from. Achieve the cornrow, you have to use extension or attachment to help catch the little hairs in front, so that it will be able to like withstand the pressure of needle and thread, and so that it doesn't loosen while cornrowing or while installing the weaves. Okay, now back to the normal all back for beginners. I would advise that you first start by sectioning her hair into two different portions. So that should be the first thing to do. Section her hair into two different portions and then control one part of the hair or one part of her hair first before you go over to control the other part of her head. And while cornrowing the first side, you just try to count how many cornrows you are cornrowing there, so that you can as well do the same number on the other side of the hair. And this will actually give you like a guide on how to make, or it will guide you to make a very simple and neat cornrow. Okay, now I'm starting from the left side of her ear, very close to her ear. Reason is because of the installation of fronter. That's why I'm actually cornrowing very close to her ear. It's because of the fronter. You guys will get to see it while I'm installing the fronter. So this weave actually is for fronter, but I'm still showing you guys how to like maneuver or how to make a simple all back. To cornrow, you just section out the main portion and then start cornrowing. Then to start up the cornrow proper, you subsection that particular main portion, the front side or her edges, you just section it into three different portions first, which will serve as a guide to make the cornrow. After that, you just go ahead to crisscross the three portions like twice. So I'm just going to allow you guys to see the demonstration very carefully. So I'm putting it on a slow motion just for you guys to really understand, especially for those of us that are beginners that do not know how to cornrow at all. So just watch the demonstration. After crisscrossing them like twice, then we start adding the back hairs gradually like so. So yeah, we'll allow you to see what I'm actually doing so that you get a better understanding. Okay, yeah, sewing cornrow or crochet cornrow, you want to like hide the tips of the previous cornrow. Okay, for a frontal cornrow, you want to cornrow the first two cornrows very close to our ear, and it should be in small size. So the both side cornrows, the first two cornrows by the side of our ears, they should be in smaller size. This should help you achieve a very well laid frontal installation. This is so that when installing or sewing in the frontal, you can easily pass the needle through it, and also so that the frontal will be very close to the ear and well installed. Okay, another trick on cornrowing or all back cornrow is the back. Usually the back are normally smaller than the front, so you have to manage the back. So when you are sectioning in portions so that you can be able to cornrow, you section out the front part bigger than the back part. So what you're actually doing is just to manage the back part so that all the hairs from the front can actually end at the back as well. So now the trick is to always manage the back part as you are cornrowing. So you have to have that at the back of your mind, that you section out big portions or big quantity in front and section out small quantity at the back. This will help make all the cornrows to reach the very end of the client's head.